Assalamu alaikum and welcome to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Prime Minister of Pakistan, Mohammad Shehbaz Sharif, is in Astana, Kazakhstan for the twin summits of SCO Council of Heads of State and SCO Plus from 3rd to 4th of July. He is accompanied by Deputy Prime Minister and Foreign Minister Mohammad Ishaq Dar and other senior members of the Cabinet and senior government officials. At the SCO Council of Heads of Summit meeting today, the Prime Minister will share Pakistan's perspective on important regional and global issues and underline the importance that Pakistan accords to regional connectivity and cooperation with SCO member states. The Prime Minister will also address the SCO Plus Summit that brings together SCO member states, invited dialogue partners, observer states, guests of the chair, and international organizations. He will share Pakistan's perspective on important regional and global issues, stressing the need for multilateralism and upholding universally recognized principles of international law. Yesterday, Prime Minister Mohammad Shehbaz Sharif participated in the first Pakistan-Azerbaijan-Turkey trilateral summit on the sidelines of SCO summit in Astana, Kazakhstan, along with President of Azerbaijan and President of Turkey. The three leaders reaffirmed commitment to alleviating tripartite cooperation, focusing on areas including trade, energy, tourism, culture, education, technology, healthcare, and environmental cooperation. The summit follows trilateral consultations at the level of foreign ministers, speakers of parliament, and defense personnel. The year 2024 is an important milestone for Pakistan-SCO relations, as Pakistan holds the rotating chairmanship of the SCO Council of Heads of Government, which is the second highest decision-making forum of SCO. In that capacity, Pakistan will host SCO Heads of Government meeting in October this year. The October summit will be preceded by a ministerial meeting and several rounds of senior official meetings focusing on financial, economic, social, cultural, and humanitarian cooperation among SCO member states. Prior to his visit to Kazakhstan, Prime Minister Mohammad Shehbaz Sharif undertook an official visit to Tajikistan on 2nd and 3rd of July at the invitation of President Rahmonov. In Dushanbe, the Prime Minister held meetings with President of Tajikistan, Imam Ali Rahmon, Chairman of Majlis Numaindagon, Mr. Zoyer, and Prime Minister Rasul Zada. The meetings focused on strengthening multifaceted cooperation between the two countries, including on regional and global issues of mutual concern. The two sides reaffirmed their commitment to deepening bilateral cooperation in diverse areas and signed 9 agreements, including cooperation between the Ministries of Foreign Affairs and cooperation in the fields of aviation, education, industry, science, sports, tourism, and trade. The two sides also signed the Pakistan-Tajikistan Strategic Partnership Agreement. The strategic partnership between Pakistan and Tajikistan will be based on 5 pillars of bilateral cooperation: political, trade and investment, energy and connectivity, security and defense, and people-to-people contacts. It will include structured high-level dialogue at the leadership and foreign ministers' levels. On 1st of July, Pakistan and India exchanged lists of prisoners in each other's custody in pursuance of the consular agreement of 2008. Pakistan handed over a list of 254 Indian and believed to be Indian civilian prisoners and fishermen in Pakistani jails. India shared a list of 452 Pakistani and believed to be Pakistani civilian prisoners and fishermen in Indian jails. a list of 38 missing Pakistani defense personnel believed to be in India's custody since the wars of 1965 and 71 were also handed over by Pakistan. Pakistan is committed to addressing this humanitarian question as a matter of priority. Last year, Pakistan released 485 Indian nationals, including 6 civilian prisoners and 479 fishermen. We will also continue our endeavors to bring Pakistani prisoners in Indian jails back to Pakistan. As a part of these efforts, repatriation of 62 Pakistani prisoners in 2023 and 4 in 2024 have taken place. Pakistan's Special Representative on Afghanistan, Ambassador Asif Ali Khan Durrani, led the Pakistan delegation at Doha 3 meeting of Special Envoys on Afghanistan held under the UN auspices in Doha from 30th June to 2nd of July. Ambassador Durrani presented Pakistan's perspective on the current situation in Afghanistan. He underscored Pakistan's support for Afghanistan to alleviate its economic situation and highlighted the threat posed by TTP-led terrorist activities originating from sanctuaries inside Afghanistan. A bilateral meeting between Pakistan and the Afghan interim government was held on 1st of July. The two sides exchanged views on key areas of mutual concern, including peace and security. The Pakistani side underscored the need for enhanced efforts to strengthen regional stability and Pakistan's commitment towards a peaceful, stable, and prosperous Afghanistan. Ambassador Durrani also underscored Pakistan's concerns about terrorist sanctuaries and support network for terrorist groups inside Afghanistan. On the sidelines, Pakistan engaged fruitfully with the delegations of the United States, China, Russia, Uzbekistan, the European Union, the UK, Norway, and the Netherlands. The Pakistan delegation also attended a quadrilateral meeting held between Pakistan, Afghanistan, Uzbekistan, and Qatar. The meeting discussed areas of mutual concern and cooperation and reviewed the Trans-Afghan Railway project connecting Pakistan with Afghanistan via Pakistan and Uzbekistan via Afghanistan. The sixth round of bilateral political consultations between Pakistan and Belarus was held in Islamabad on 2nd of July. Additional Foreign Secretary Europe, Ambassador Shafkat Ali Khan, led the Pakistan side, while the Belarusian side was headed by First Deputy Minister Sergei Lukashevich. Pakistan categorically rejects the baseless assertions made about Pakistan in the recent report on religious freedom released by the U.S. Department of State. As a matter of principle, Pakistan opposes such unilateral reports that make observations on internal affairs of sovereign states. We believe that international religious freedom cannot be viewed from the lens of any single country's social and legal perspective. Unilateral reports assessing other countries' human rights situations are not free from political bias and present an incomplete and distorted picture. The methodology adopted in preparing these reports and the mandate and expertise of its authors are not transparent. It is unfortunate that the report refers to certain incidents in Pakistan last year without highlighting the strong political will shown by the government of Pakistan to hold the perpetrators accountable, as well as the remedial efforts undertaken and the legal and administrative protections in place for religious minorities. We strongly believe that each state itself has the primary responsibility to to promote and protect religious freedoms and rights of its nationals. Pakistani citizens are entitled to freedom of religion and belief under the law as enshrined in Pakistan's constitution. These rights and constitutional guarantees are protected, upheld, and reinforced by an independent judiciary. Such unilateral reports, therefore, do not contribute to the promotion of human rights. The government of Pakistan has announced to allow medical students from Gaza to complete their medical education in Pakistan. The decision was made on the directions of Deputy Prime Minister and Foreign Minister Mohammad Ishaq Dar by the Pakistan Medical and Dental Council. This would enable the students of Gaza to continue their medical education in Pakistan on humanitarian grounds. The Palestinian students from Gaza will soon join Pakistani medical colleges in batches of 20 to 30. This decision would enable Gaza students to complete their medical education in Pakistan in the fields of cardiology, orthopedics, oncology, pediatrics, and surgery to address the critical needs in Gaza's healthcare system. The Indian authorities' campaign to crush dissent in the Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir remains relentless. A prominent Kashmiri leader and former president of the High Court Bar Association, Mia Abdul Qayyum, has recently been arrested on fabricated charges. He suffers from multiple chronic ailments and old age. His arrest is a clear act of political vendetta. We urge the Indian authorities to release Mia Abdul Qayyum and thousands of other Kashmiri political prisoners, dissenters, and human rights defenders. Pakistan will continue to extend political, diplomatic, and moral support to our Kashmiri brothers and sisters for the just settlement of the Jammu and Kashmir dispute in accordance with the UN Security Council resolutions. I thank you.